Hi, Jim Shaw here from Crystal Group, taking just a moment to do a little bit deeper dive into mill standard 810. There's been some interest in going down a little bit deeper into 810 and talking about some of the methods and procedures that are more common in some of the testing that we in the industry are subjected to. And so I thought we'd talk today about method 500, which is low pressure or altitude. And so this test method essentially has four procedures that you can test to. The purpose of the test is really looking at storing things at high altitude or operating them at high altitude or transporting them at high altitude. And so the testing that is done around these kinds of environments are really intended to look for leaking gaskets or deformation of containers or sealed containers bursting. And so you're looking for problems specific to what happens in altitude when you're taking your unit to and from someplace, or you're trying to operate it in that kind of an environment. And so, well, what kind of heights are we talking about here? And generally, you're in the 15,000 feet to 40,000 foot range in this test spec, depending on what it is that you're trying to do, whether it's transportation or operation. There are four test procedures in this method. They are essentially storage, they are operations, they are rapid decompression, and then explosive decompression. And so we talked a little bit about, well, what are you looking for? Gaskets leaking, rupturing containers, things like that. In the electronics industry, we're most concerned about overheating. That's probably one of the bigger issues that we deal with. And essentially, you know, it stands to reason, as you go up in altitude, air density decreases, so your mass flow rate is in effect reduced. Mass flow rate of air is how you get things cool. Therefore, things get warmer much easier when you're up in the altitude. So that becomes the challenge. You're also looking for things like arcing components, anything that's high voltage. Air is a great dielectric, so you don't get spark gap types of situations. There are four procedures. The storage procedure is essentially, you know, can you store a box or a unit for a period of time at a higher altitude? There is an operational procedure. It talks about, can you operate a box in a mountainous environment or on an aircraft? There is a transportation procedure that talks about whether or not you can safely transport the box. Is there any damage when you fly it in an unpressurized cargo hold from the United States to anywhere of your choice? And then the last one, which is a little more interesting, is rapid decompression. And that is essentially where, take an extreme where you're flying at 40,000 feet in a pressurized container or cargo hold, and there is an accident, or the aircraft has a mishap, and essentially there is a rapid decompression. Say it's around a tenth of a millisecond from one altitude to the other, or one pressure to the other. And so in that case, you're looking for, do you have any damage to the unit after it's undergone that type of pressure change? So these are all standard tests. We see more of the operational test and rapid decompression tests as being the more common ones that we do here. You can also find similar types of testing requirements in specs like DO-160, STANAG 4370. So there's several of these types of test methods out there. There's a European spec, an EN spec, an IEC spec. So that's just one of the test methods that's out here that we're most familiar with, and that's mill standard 810 500. Thanks a lot.
Join us next time for another shiny object at Crystal Group.